He is the knower of all things. Ponder over the knowledge of Allah and khudha qasam here and now. You will begin to prostrate before the master. وَمَا تَسْكُتُ مِنْ وَرَقَةٍ إِلَّا يَعْلَمُهَا وَلَا حَبَّةٍ فِي ظُلَمَاتِ الْأَرْضِ وَلَا رَتْبٍ وَلَا يَابِسٍ إِلَّا فِي كِتَابٍ مُبِينٍ. There is not a single leaf that falls, whether this leaf is in the darkness of the Amazon basin, whether this leaf is in the thickness of some jungle, whether this leaf falls from a tree which is on the peak of some mountain. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He knows the color of that leaf. He knows the size of that leaf. He knows the hour that this leaf fell. He knows the second that this leaf touches the ground. وَلَا حَبَّةٍ فِي ظُلَمَاتِ الْأَرْضِ. There is not even a grain in the darkness of the earth, but it is in the knowledge of Allah. اللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ مَا تَحْمِلُ كُلُّ أُنْثَى اللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ مَا تَحْمِلُ كُلُّ أُنْثَى وَمَا تَغِيدُ الْأَرْحَامُ وَمَا تَزْدَادُ وَكُلُّ شَيْءٍ عِنْدَهُ بِمِقْدَارٍ عَالِمُ الْغَيْبِ وَالشَّهَادَةِ الْكَبِيرُ الْمُتَعَالِ سَوَاءٌ مِنْكُمْ مَنْ أَسَرَّ الْقَوْلَ وَمَنْ جَهَرَ بِهِ وَمَنْ هُوَ مُسْتَخْفٍ بِاللَّيْلِ وَصَارِبٌ بِالنَّهَارِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what every female bears and how and by how much these wombs fall short or exceed. Everything with Allah is within a due proportion. He is the knower of the seen and the unseen, the most great, the most high. سَوَاءٌ مِنْكُمْ. It is equal to Him whether one of you conceals his speech, or whether one of you declares it openly, or whether one of you goes hidden by the night, or goes open by the day. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows it all. يَا بُنَيَّا إِنَّهَا إِنْ تَكُمْ مِسْكَالَ حَبَّةٍ مِّنْ خَرْدَلْ فَتَكُنْ فِي سَخْرَةٍ أَوْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ أَوْ فِي الْأَرْضِ يَأْتِي بِهَا اللَّهُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَطِيفٌ خَبِيرٌ. O insan, even if there's something equal to the weight of a mustard seed, and then this thing is inside some rock, in the darkness of a rock, or is inside somewhere in the heavens or the earth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He knows of this thing, and He will bring it forth on the day of judgment. Why? وَمَا يَأْذَوَ أَرَّبِّكَ مِنْ مِسْكَالِ ذَرَّةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَا فِي السَّمَاءِ وَلَا أَصْغَرَ مِنْ ذَلِكَ وَلَا أَكْبَرَ إِلَّا فِي كِتَابٍ مُبِينٍ. Because nothing can stay hidden from Him, even if it is equal to the weight of an atom, or it is smaller than this, nothing can stay hidden from Him. Why? Allahu ya'lamu, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows. He knows what enters the earth. He knows what comes out from the earth. وَمَا يَنزُلُ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ وَمَا يَعْرُجُ فِيهَا. He knows what descends from the heavens. He knows what ascends to the heavens. Never mind this. رَبُّكُمْ أَعْلَمُ بِكُمْ. You sit here before me and you think you know yourself. The Almighty Allah knows you better than yourself. يَعْلَمُ خَائِنَةُ الْأَعْيُنِ وَمَا تُخْفِي الصُّدُورِ. He even knows the fraud of your eyes and what your heart conceals. You sit here listening to the reminder as I address you, and the thoughts that are crossing your mind, the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala already knows these thoughts before they even cross your mind. This is the Almighty Allah. And when you ponder over the greatness, when you ponder over the knowledge of the Almighty Allah, you will bow down in prostration and you will recognize that greatness belongs to the Almighty Allah. Look at this earth that you live in. Allahu Akbar. Look at the size of this earth. Look at the things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created inside this earth. Then ponder over at the speed at which this earth is traveling at this moment in time as you listen to the reminder, yet you are firm on this earth. It has no effect on you. When you ponder over this, the speed at which it's traveling, and it has no effect on those that live within it, you realize that the greatness is for the Almighty Allah. Look at this sun above you. It is a sunny day. Ponder over the sun. Look at the size of the sun. Look at the diameter of the sun. Look at the core temperature of the sun. Hundreds and thousands, hundreds of times bigger than this earth. When you ponder over this, you realize that the greatness is for the Almighty Allah. Then when you ponder over the solar system, you ponder over these planets that you learn about in schools, Mercury, Jupiter, Mars, Pluto, Venus, these planets, and then you ponder over that our solar system is 30,000 light years away from the center of the galaxy, you realize that the greatness is for the Almighty Allah. After this, when somebody tells you that there are solar systems bigger than our solar systems, you realize that the greatness is for the Almighty Allah. And then when you ponder and you are informed that there are millions of galaxies within the universe, you realize that the greatness is for the Almighty Allah. And then when you are informed that you sit here right now, وَالسَّمَاءَ بَنَيْنَاهَا بِأَيْدٍ وَإِنَّ لَمُوسِعُونَ, that at this moment in time, as you listen to the reminder that this universe as it stands is being expanded by the second, when you ponder over this, you realize that the greatness is for the Almighty Allah. And after this, when somebody tells you, after this, there are seven heavens, بَيْنَ السَّمَاءِ الدُّنْيَا وَالَّتِي تَلِيهَا خَمْسُ مِيَا عَامٍ, the distance between the first heaven and the second heaven is of 500 years. The distance between the second and the third is 500 years. The distance between the third and fourth is 500 years. The distance difference between the fourth and fifth is 500 years. Fifth and sixth is 500 years. Sixth and seventh is 500 years. Allahu Akbar, you will recognize that the greatness is for the Almighty Allah and Allah alone. And after this, if somebody was to tell you, after this comes the kursi of Allah, وَسِعَ كُرْسِيهُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَلَا يُؤُذُ وَحِفْظُهُمَا وَهُوَ الْعَلِيُّ الْعَظِيمُ, the distance between the seventh heaven and the kursi is of 500 years. And all these heavens put together in comparison to the kursi are nothing. They're like a ring in the desert. After you will, when you ponder over this, you will realize that greatness is for the Almighty Allah. After this, if somebody was to tell you, after this comes the arsh of the Almighty Allah, the arsh of the Almighty Allah, the seven heavens and the kursi put together in comparison to the arsh of Allah is nothing. It's like a ring in a desert. When you ponder over this, you will realize that there is greatness for the Almighty Allah. Then when somebody tells you that after this there are angels carrying the arsh of Allah, and such is the state of these angels, يَرُؤُسُهُمْ قَجَّابَزَتْ السَّمَاءَ السَّابِعَةَ, their heads are above the seven heavens and their feet are firm in the lowest earth. مَا بَيْنَ شَحْمَةِ أُذُنِهِ إِلَىٰ آتِقِهِ مَصِيرَةُ سَبَ مِيَعَامْ بِخَفْكِ التَّيْرِ وَحَدِيثٌ صَحِيحٌ, and the distance between the earlobe, Allahu Akbar, look at the distance between our earlobe and our neck, it is nothing. The distance between the earlobe and the neck of these angels is such that it would take a bird 700 years to cover this distance. When you ponder over this, you will realize that the greatness is for the Almighty Allah. After the arsh, when somebody comes and tell you there are 70,000 worlds of nur and darkness, when you ponder over this, you will realize that the greatness is for the Almighty Allah. And all this, what I've told you now and what I've talked about, the heavens, the earth, the solar system, the galaxies and the universe itself, if somebody was to tell you Allahu Akbar, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has such power that all that I have mentioned, He can put it to an end within a trillionth of a second, you will realize that the greatness is for the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then when you ponder over the day of judgment and you ponder over the verses of the Quran, وَالسَّمَاوَاتُ مَطْوِيَّاتٌ بِيَمِينِهِ, that the whole earth, Allahu Akbar, this earth will be grasped in His hand. Can you imagine like holding a tennis ball and playing about with it and throwing it up and down? This earth will be grasped by the Almighty Allah on the day of judgment. And these seven heavens, which I've just told you how big they are, your mind cannot get over this. My mind cannot even comprehend the size of the heavens. The Quran says, وَالسَّمَاوَاتُ مَطْوِيَّاتٌ بِيَمِينِهِ, that these heavens will be rolled up in His right hands. And the Almighty Allah will say on the day of judgment, أَنَا الْمَلِكُ أَيْنَ مُلُوكِ الْأَرْضِ, that I am the king. I am the king of all kings. Where are the kings of the dunya today? Where are your Gorbachevs? Where are your Bushes? Where are your Blairs? When nobody answers, everybody will be dumbfounded. Everybody will be speechless. Everybody, their heads will be on the floor. They will be on prostration. When you see this on the day of judgment, you will acknowledge Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allah is the greatest and greatness is for the Almighty Allah. Then when you think of the Hashr, when you think of the resurrection, how the Almighty Allah will bring back every single creation, every single thing that the Almighty Allah will has created, how He will put it back together. فَإِذَا هُمْ كَيَامُ يَنْظُرُونَ, when you ponder over this, you will realize that the greatness is for the Almighty Allah. Even if somebody was to drown in the ocean, for example, somebody was to drown inside the ocean, he's died inside the ocean, millions of different fish come, and they come and they eat from his flesh, and then these fish go, and there is nothing remains except for bones. Then the waves come, and they take these bones, and they throw them onto land, they throw them onto shore. The bones have been there for days, the bones have decayed. Come a few days after, the camels come, and the camels eat from here, and then the camels in turn drop droppings, and then what happens is, a group of people come, and they take these droppings, and they use them as fuel. A fire is lit. After a while, the fire is put out. Come the wind, and it takes these ashes, and it throws them to different corners of the world. Allahu Akbar, come the sound of the horn, come the command of Allah, and those that are inside their graves, and those that died in this manner, فَإِذَا هُمْ كَيَامُ يَنْظُرُونَ, in the eyes of Allah, they will be equal, and He will gather them exactly the same, and they will be standing, and they will be looking on. When you ponder over this, you realize that the greatness is for the Almighty Allah. Then when you ponder over the gathering, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make every living being that has ever been created, how Allah will make them to gather on a flat white plain. It will be the greatest congregation ever seen. Can you imagine? Every man that Allah ever created will be on that plain of resurrection. Every woman that Allah ever created will be on that plain of resurrection. Every male jinn that Allah ever created will be on that plain of resurrection. Every female jinn that Allah ever created will be on the plane of resurrection. It will be the greatest congregation ever seen.